Hey, what's up guys? It's Ivan, and in this video I want to show you how to create a landing page with Kartra. Now this is going to be the first of this series of the free course, but just because I'm doing this first doesn't mean that you too have to start with this. You can start with whatever you want, whether it's adding a product, setting up an email, automation, setting up your help desk or your calendar, it doesn't matter, but I'm doing this in a way that seems the most intuitive to me, all right? So let's get into it. So we're gonna first go over here, head over into pages, and this is where we're gonna create our landing page. And in an upcoming video, this is where we're also going to create our website and our sales page as well, okay? So the first thing we wanna do is click over here, click on page, and we're gonna select what we want. So for this video, we're gonna start with a landing page, right? A squeeze page. So we can just select squeeze page here on the left so that it only shows us the squeeze pages. And we can preview any one. For the purpose of this course, let's suppose we want to promote my free guide as a giveaway, right? So our freebie is going to be my free 55 page guide, which I am indeed offering on my website, ivanmena.com. And then for what we want to sell, let's suppose it's going to be a course, let's say a Google Ads course. Okay. So that's what we're going to be doing for this Kartra course for all these videos in the series. Okay. So let's take a look at something that we like. Like let's suppose this one, for example, we click on preview. And by the way, you might notice that it says placeholder here. And that's because we do need to create a form in a separate form builder with Kartra, which is gonna be right over here on the left. So we will do that in the next video, in the next section. But for now, we can pick a very simple landing page. I don't wanna make it too complicated. I think this one actually looks pretty good. So let's go ahead and click on select. And let's give it a name. So let's say, let's just say affiliate marketing guide, because that's what I'm offering. And then you would enter a category for what sort of category it belongs in. I already have a few categories here, but what you can do is you can click on manage my categories, and then you can quickly delete and add the ones you want. So actually I'm gonna go ahead and delete the financial advisor one. I'm gonna delete health and fitness one. And let's suppose I'm gonna keep this one as an online marketing one, right? And let's suppose you end up wanting to create different funnels, different landing pages. Well, you can create another category, which is what I had here before, which was health and fitness. You can click done, right? So that way it's a little bit easier to organize things. So we're gonna go ahead and click done. And so we're gonna select this online marketing category. And for the site, this is pretty cool. So when you create a bunch of pages together, like a landing page that then goes to a thank you page, which goes to a sales page, you want to integrate them together under one bundle, which is going to be one site, right? So they might be under one category, like online marketing, but you might have different sites under each category. And so that's what we're going to do here. So in this case, I'm going to click on manage my sites, and we have this one. So let's suppose we want to delete that. And we're gonna give a name for this. So this is gonna be our, let's say, affiliate marketing training site, right? So this website and everything included is gonna be included here. And then we don't have any pages yet, so we have nothing to select, but we're gonna create this site here. We're gonna click done. And so now this specific landing page will be added under this site and this category. Now we could import all global elements from a site. So if we have an existing site, then we could kind of have the same theme, but we currently don't have that, so we can just leave it as is and click on create. And this is now going to take us to the page builder. So get familiar with this page builder, because it's going to be pretty much the same for our sales page, for our thank you page, for our membership site, you know, things like that. It's going to be pretty similar. So this is our page. I like it, but let's suppose I want to add an image here of my guide, right? And let's suppose I want actually the image to be on the left and this to be on the right. So let me quickly give you a rundown of kind of what this looks like, what this is. So the first option here is you can choose by specific components, which are like specific elements, or you can choose by columns, and columns are where you put those elements, right? So we're going to stick with components here. You have page settings over here, so you can adjust your SEO parameters. So this is your you know, page title, meta description, all that stuff. We're gonna leave it as is for now. You have the tracking code you could add here. You can add different tags as well. So people that visit this page will automatically be assigned a tag, things like that. Page redirect, you can set a redirect so that a page instantly redirects to something else. But we're not gonna use it. I don't think we need to. We're gonna stick with the basic stuff. You have page styles where you can change your page background, change your content description, you know, everything over here. You can go ahead and play around with it. Then you have sections. So these are like the big sections, like this whole thing where you see the picture, the text, that is a section, right? And then within the section, you're going to have your components. So that's where you're going to be dragging those components. You have pop-ups. You can create a pop-up, an alert bar, which is like that bar at the top. You have your help desk, which is basically your, it's going to be like a little icon. Let's say if you use a help desk, which I do have one set up, but we're going to go over that. So don't worry about it, where it's basically going to say get help in the bottom right of the page. Okay. So we're not going to do that here. Then you have your code. So if you want to add specific code into a specific component, you can do that here. And that's pretty much it for all of that. Okay, so now that you're familiar with everything and all these options, we can go in and make the changes. So the first thing I want to do is I like my images to be on the left more, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to drag this, we're going to drop it over here. And then this, I believe, is a column, actually. Let's see, this whole thing. Yeah, so you can see the column by the blue, right? You see that blue there. So actually, now that I'm thinking of it, I didn't grab it. Grab it again. We're going to drag this. We're going to move it into here, into this column. So just the way it was. And then what I want to do is I want to move this column. So I'm going to drag this column, move it here, and then boom, right? So then it just kind of swapped. So it's much easier than moving around the individual elements. And then I want to change this image. So I'm going to go into components now, because this is an individual component. I'm going to click on edit style. And then this is where you can change everything you want about the image. I love how you can change the image opacity and the image blur as well. So that's pretty cool. That's something you normally have to do with a third-party tool. Kartra has it all here for you, right? Everything integrated. So it has much more than just a standalone landing page builder. And then, so over here, we're going to go, into image. And let's go ahead and replace our image. So we're going to click edit. And then I'm going to go ahead and select my image, which I already uploaded into that media folder. But if you want to upload a new image, you just click on select files over here. So I'm just going to click check mark here, click confirm, and then click apply. And we're going to close out of that. And it doesn't look like it's showing up. Let's see. Sorry, I believe that's because we made the image opacity zero. We want it to be 100. Oops. There you go. So that looks good, okay? You don't really have as much customization in terms of like if you wanna make the image smaller, you wanna make it bigger, you wanna like move it a little bit to the left. You don't really have that. You have to stick in blocks really with Kartra, but that should still be fine. And really the default templates that they give you are really more than enough for what you have available, okay? So this looks good, I'm good here. So let's go ahead and change this title here now. So let's say, get your free affiliate marketing guide. And then over here, we're going to say, learn how to make money with affiliate marketing and how to get started today, for example, right? And then you see that there's a lot of space over here. Box. What we want to do is we want to change the column. So we're going to come in here. We're going to look for this column, the blue one. And so when you come down over here to where it says vertical alignment, you can see that this image is like aligned at the bottom, so we don't want that, right? So if we want to align it center, it's going to be like this. Or if we want to align it at the top, it would select that. I think the center is good, right? So make it even with the image. And then if we click on this image as well, this is aligned, let's say center. Yeah, so now they're even like that. And you can, of course, if you click on these pencil icons as well, you can play around with the padding, right? So if you want to add a little more space from the top, detract a little space, things like that, you can do that. And so that looks good. Don't worry about the form. We will configure it in the next section, and then we're going to come back and add it. But for now, this is what we have here. So we're going to scroll down. You know what? Let's just keep things simple. I don't think we need this section. So I'm going to go ahead and select that little gear icon, and we're just going to delete that because we want to make a simple, simple landing page, right? What our customers say, subscribe now. Yeah, so here we can add the same form. So we can say something like, let's click on components. I want to say, for example, get started now. Let's suppose we want to change the color of the text. So we're going to make it, let's say, bluish like that. I don't like this pink. So let's click here and let's click edit. And let's adjust the background color. Let's make it bluish, which is more so the color of my site. Click on apply, and now it's a little more blue. You can also click on background. You can add an image, which is what I believe they have here, right? They have this image with the little hexagons there, delay, or you can hide it if you like on certain devices, desktop, mobile, tablet, so on and so forth. So that looks good. And then over here, get your free 55-page affiliate marketing guide and start potentially earning money today. I make no get rich quick, you know, make money right away promises. I highly suggest you guys have a job, a steady job first before you do affiliate marketing. Absolutely. And then over here, let's say copyright by. We're going to change this to say Yvonne Mana Inc. We can have the one dot. You can click here on each icon and you can edit it. So you got to be careful with how you click just because it doesn't really do a good job here. Like you got to really be careful. Like that, for example, for Twitter, you come in here, you click on link, and then you would link to your Twitter profile, right? That's how you would change that. For the logo, let me go ahead and add that because I didn't add the logo in my profile settings as I suggested that you should do. So we're just going to do that here. And actually, yeah, there you go. So we have that, right? We're going to work on that form. What our customers say, we can leave that. And actually, the guide is teal, right? So maybe let's see if we wanna keep it maintain consistency. So we're gonna come into here, click on edit, and then we want to copy this, okay? Then we're gonna come down here and use the same color just to maintain that consistency. Click on apply, and now it looks a little more similar. And then actually, let's suppose for this text as well, click on more colors. That should do it. So looks pretty good. Looks pretty good. What our customers say. So let me just at least change this. Let's say join the list of happy. I don't want to say customers because it's a free guide. Join the list of happy people who downloaded this free guide. Let's just say that, right? And then you can come in here and just say nice things. Let's say this guide was incredible. And then we're just gonna keep it simple. Like that, okay? So just at least so we have something that's not like just in Latin, right? And so this is our landing page, okay? So we're pretty much done with this. So let's go ahead and create our thank you page, and then we are going to create our form and add the form in here, okay? And like I said, there's no one linear path for how you have to do this. You could go in and do your form first and then come back and do your landing page, but every part you do does require the other part. So if you do your form, for example, it's going to ask you for the link to your thank you page, right? Because after somebody completes the form, they need to go to a thank you page. So there's no real right answer. You can also show columns here. You can turn autosave on, which is what I do recommend. And as far as I can tell, the page does look good. If we want to add a little more space here, though, if I click on columns here and we click on, actually, we can click on edit the whole kind of the whole section. We can come over here and then increase the margin a little bit. And that is just going to increase more space there. Okay. So that I think looks a little better. So let's go ahead and hit save progress. We can also preview to see what the page looks like. So let's go ahead and preview in here and open preview. And this is our landing page. Okay. So I am indeed offering a affiliate marketing guide. What our customers say, and boom. Okay. So very simple, very straightforward landing page. It looks really nice. I think it looks very professional. Alternatively, by the way, what you could also do is you don't need to have like a form. What you could do is you can go into components and you can add a button. So play around with all these. There's just so many options for me to just, you know, cover in one video. I think it'll take a few hours to just go over in detail like every single thing, but everything is really straightforward. You just drag anything you need. So if you wanted to, you could drag this button. Sorry. So you have to click the button and then you would select the button and then you would drag it. So let's put the button here, but actually, for example, let's suppose we want to drag it a little bit lower right there, right? So that's going to be our button. So instead of a form, you could have a pop-up form. So, right? So if you click on edit button here, you can click on link and then you can click pop and opt-in form. And then we're going to create our form, right? But basically it's going to be a pop-up. So if you want to do it that way instead, you could, but we're not going to do that. So We're just going to click done over here, and then we're going to remove this button. Just an option that I wanted to share with you. So, like I said, we're good here. Let's go ahead and publish this live, and then let's quickly do our thank you page, and then we'll move on to the next section. So this is going to be our page link. Okay, so we can copy it. Let's see what it looks like. And boom, here it is. I'm pretty happy with it. I think it looks pretty good for a landing page. We could also get the code and upload it on your server, on your website, but I'm not too familiar with it, to be honest. And for those of us using Kartra, I think we're mainly using it for like an all-in-one solution, right? Not to publish it somewhere else, right? So once we're good with that, we're gonna click return to dashboard, and we're good with this. So now let's go ahead and add a thank you page so that we can integrate the two. And so after somebody submits the form, which we'll create in the next section, they'll go to the thank you page. So we're gonna click on page over here, and let's select thank you pages over here. And you see all these templates over here. You could, of course, start with a blank page and start completely fresh. That's up to you. I'm going to, let's see which one looks good. Thank you for registering. Thank you for registering. I think something simple and straightforward like this one should be okay. I don't think we need something too complicated. So we're gonna say affiliate marketing guide, and then we're gonna say thank you page, right? Not to confuse it with our sales page, for example. So there's a limit, so let's say thank you page. Category, this is indeed online marketing, and the site, it is the affiliate marketing. We're good as is. So now let's just go ahead and change this up a little bit again. So again, we're gonna click on edit style. Give it a second to load. We're gonna click on image here. We're gonna change the image to our logo. We're gonna hit apply. And then that looks fine. We're going to say thank you. You have successfully signed up for our guide. Go ahead and download your freebie. And then this button, we're going to allow them to download the file, right? So I already downloaded the file. So what we can do is we can click on link. So we're going to click on the button, click on link, and then we're going to select download a file. And then we're going to scroll down, select the file, and it's going to be a document. And because I already uploaded the file to that media section that I told you about, we can just select it from here. But you could just go ahead and select the file, drag and drop it over here, and use it the same thing. So we're just going to select that. And so now when somebody clicks on this button, they will download this guide, right? It's actually going to show up in their browser window, and I'm going to show you here in a second. So I think that looks good. Again, it's very, very straightforward. There's nothing really to see here except maybe this. I did start my brand actually in 2017, so that looks good. We're gonna say save progress, and then we're going to publish live, and then we're gonna see what it looks like. So let's get the code link. If we paste it here, if we click on download now, you're gonna see the download right away, right? And then people can just download it. They can click the download button here and it'll be downloaded to their phone. So this is the short version of my guide. My actual guide is 55 pages long, I believe. So this is just like the first 8 pages, but just so we can use something as an example, right? So if you want the guide yourself, just head over to yvonnemeta.com, and I do offer you the guide there. So that is how that works. So let's go ahead and come back now. Let's return to dashboard. So we have all these. And so now what we're going to do in the next section is create our form so that we can come back in here and enter the form on our landing page, all right? And again, if you guys don't have Kartra yet, if you want to take advantage of an exclusive offer, if you go to go.yvonnemeta.com/Kartra, I do give you a 30-day free trial and a 20% off on your first month after the trial is over. So an exclusive offer you cannot get just by going to kartra.com. So make sure to take advantage of it. That said, that is it for this section. I will see you in the next one.